almost everyone must be starting their conversation, Tapsee, by saying how they admire you and the roles that you do and the performances that you give. I must add my voice to it.
Okay.
You've really done some remarkable work.
Thank you.
And before I come to that, I must share a small anecdote. I, of course, know of her as a performing artist. But this afternoon, we were on the same flight. And it was wonderful to see that she walked into the cabin. There was no attendant with her. She was alone. She picked up her own bag, which was reasonably heavy, I thought, and then put it there. And then when she got off the flight, she just took her trolley and just walked all the way, all by yourself. Wonderful. I saw humility there, and I saw self-confidence. Wonderful.
Yeah, I think I'm strong enough to handle my own bag. Let's just say that.
It's good, very good to see that. So, Tapsee, let's begin with your own journey and your own success story. Did you grow up in a very conservative social setting?
Not probably as conservative as majority of India. But yes, since I belong to a very conventional middle-class family of Delhi, I pretty much had a very, say, let's say an average conservative childhood where, you know, it's not at all okay to question things or think out of the box or be unconventional in any way. So, yeah, that's how my upbringing was. Everything is like, the rules are laid by the society and you're just there to follow it. And you're not supposed to do anything that's not okay with the society.
Yeah, the society as in relatives, people,
yeah, that
neighbors.
Thing, everyone, all of
yeah.
them. The life of, your own life is governed by log kya kahenge. That is what I used to keep hearing. It's not about what you want to do or what is right or wrong. It's about will people approve of it or not.
So I'll come back a bit to the choices you made. But tell me, within, from you know, as a young lady who grew up in that environment, to someone who pulled off this amazing role in Man Marziyan, even by Western standards,
yeah.
the kind of choices the woman makes in the film
yeah.
are bold, even by Western Hollywood standards. I mean, I've seen
yeah.
few Hollywood films which do that. Did you ever think that you would be in such a liberal setting where you could do that within, say, a decade of you know, becoming an adult?
Well, when you're an Anurag Kashyap set, you can think and do whatever you want to do.
But society
well, I knew that I'm getting into something that's not going to be welcomed that easily. But yes, I knew there'll be a lot of young women out there who'll finally feel, okay, I am not abnormal. If they can show it in a movie, it is real. It can happen. So that, I knew my female audience will definitely agree.
You were confident?
Yeah, I was confident. I've never gotten such long love letters from females ever. Even during Pink, it happened, but this was like, my WhatsApp was buzzing with long letters. My Facebook messenger was going on like these long letters with hearts of girls that finally, you know, to thank you for portraying us on screen. Yeah, and I remember I went for a Florence Film Festival where Man Marziyan was the closing film, and there was a foreigner there, a German person, who asked me, I can't believe this film is made in India. They actually called a female, horny, and she's okay with it.
That's right.
So I was like, okay, that's the first time someone had so, in such a blunt, like in so many words, asked me that obvious question. Yes, this character has her needs and she's pretty confident about the fact that she's normal and it's okay to have these needs and this is how it is. It's okay if a man says that, you know, I've been with these many women, and it's very sad that when if a woman tries to say the same thing, she is an outcast.
Any trolling, any hate mail?
Of course.
A lot of it.
My life is full of them.
No.
My career is full of them. Let's just say that.
More from men or only from men?
Mostly from men.
Mm-hmm.
Mostly from men. Yeah, be it, you know, the people who thought, okay, because I portrayed a character who's a Sikh, and I'm myself a Sikh. So there were guys out there who said, oh, you are a Sikh, you can't be smoking. Oh, you are a Sikh, you cannot be thinking about another man while you're getting married to someone else. Which religion or which god said you need to control someone's thinking. My God didn't. I don't know which religion do they belong to, because my religion definitely gives me this much of right to think whatever I want to do. And we never said that this character is going to be doing the righteous things. And when she's doing something wrong, she is a character who is flawed. But that's okay. I'm not showing you a documentary or a book of, you know, what is right or wrong. I'm just showing you the reality where some people exist who do wrong things. And it's okay. You know, I'm not asking you to, I'm not professing or propagating that. So that should be accepted. But it was not. There were a lot of people who questioned. I remember there was one director I knew, and his wife was telling me that, don't you think it is spreading wrong things in the society that it's okay to go with your boyfriend when you are married to a man, and you know this is not a right thing? And I'm like, since when did we start judging moral values, or you know, when did our books transform into films?
Interesting. Yeah. I was very curious to know what kind of response you got. And this is very heartening that you got a lot of support from women, you are saying, across demographics, yeah, across ages, across, yes, social settings.
Yes.
That's, yeah, remarkable.
Yeah. Even the middle-aged women, like my, yeah, mom's age women, there were girls who came up to me and said, my mother really loved your film. And there were women who said, you know, who came out with tears in their eyes, and they were like, middle-aged women who were like, okay, this could be me. I'm like, okay. Yes. So after so many years, probably, yes, into marriage.
Yeah, yeah, remarkable. I know, Ritu and I, we saw the film with our two mothers, who were 70s and 80s. And they were fine with the film. And I said, you know, India is changing. This tells me India
is
changing.
It is. It is time to think out of the box, to question the conditioning. I think it's time.
Yeah, it's quite remarkable. Tell me, let's go back to the fact that you, when you were studying, clearly your engineering choice, was it your choice or your father's choice?
No, honestly, it was my choice.
Your choice?
Yes, because I was one of those front bencher, studious, nerdy kids.
What engineering did you do?
I'm a CSC engineer, computer science and engineering.
Wow, okay.
Yes, yeah, so yeah. I loved studying. I love maths, unlike what people usually think of actors to be. I loved maths, I loved physics, and that's the reason why I took up engineering, because I realized I cannot mug up big answers in business studies, so there's no point getting into that side. And biology and all also had a lot of things to like really cram up, which I couldn't. So maths was my thing, so I decided be an engineer.
And but then why did you flunk CAT?
Oh God, that was the most disheartening thing. 2 days back, my cousin is sending me, or forwarded the email I sent to her after I flunked in CAT, where I thought my life has come to an end.
Right? Yes.
Yeah, it is over. I'm no good. And I should just like go and do, or probably just redo or relive my life to be good for something. I was very upset. I thought I could cross 90 percentile, and I did not. And that was a big shock for me, because I used to be the studious kind, you know, the competitive studious kind who always is used to getting good marks. And this was not okay for someone like me.
Why the flip to film?
I had 1 year to while away after my engineering got over, and I was placed in Infosys. I had a campus placement.
Oh, you had a campus placement?
Yeah.
You worked at Infosys?
No, I did not. I just had an appointment letter.
Oh, you had
letter.
An appointment letter?
Yeah, I had an appointment letter. That was just to prove to my father that if I want to, I can get a job. It's just that I don't want to. I want to study further, because midway through my engineering, I realized I don't want to be an engineer. I love studying is why I'm doing my engineering.
Were you going to be in Bangalore, Infosys campus?
Yeah, Mysore. No, Mysore.
At the training.
Yeah, the training there first, okay. Yeah. So okay. Then I 1 year was there for me to prepare for CAT again before I give my exam. And that's when that 1 year, I thought, okay, for a person like me who's used to doing 5 things at the same time, one thing at a time will not really work for my brain. So I thought, let me do something else as well. And I was getting a lot of movie offers because of a little bit of pocket money modeling I did during my college days. And I took up those movie offers. And and then it was fun in the beginning, but it turned out to be very difficult to learn a craft that I've never done in my life before. I've never taken part in any skit, play, drama, nothing. And then language, because I started off in South thinking, how does it matter? Kya farak padta hai?
So did you have to speak the language or you're dubbed?
Yeah. You speak the language, but eventually you get dubbed. But at least that time you
while
have to
shooting,
speak
yeah.
the language.
So Telugu, Kannada?
Telugu, Tamil, both of them together. One Tamil, one Telugu film together simultaneously. And I was being way too adventurous with my life, I realized. But yeah, the first films, I think they made me realize that life is something that happens to you while you're busy making plans. That really showed me the reality.
To conclude, I mean, women who want to achieve, young girls who are stepping out with an ambition, what would you say is the most important thing? Is it about not quitting? Is it about being a conforming rebel? I mean, you rebel, but you don't become ugly about it.
Yeah.
You assert yourself, but you don't become ugly about it.
See, I feel women or females are synonymous with grace. Mm-hmm. You can be a wrestler. You can be a dancer. You are born graceful. You can never change that about yourself. So you should always have a touch with that graceful part of your life, which is going to be your biggest weapon. Mm-hmm. Be ready that it is not going to be easy. Well, anyway, it's not easy for either sometimes, for males as well. But for you, it might be a little more difficult. Be ready for that from day one. Because it's when you keep yourself mentally prepared that it's not going to come easy, you have to fight larger battles. So you're conditioned and ready for it. And when you're going through it, just make sure you keep telling yourself, you know yourself better than anyone else who tries to tell you, you cannot do this, or you cannot be there, or you're not good enough for this. Just know one thing, you know yourself better than anybody else.
And don't quit, right?
Of course. I mean, that will never make you quit.
Yeah. Perhaps we could go on and on, but it's wonderful to have this
thank
conversation.
Thank you so much.
I can now tell the world that I've met you in flesh and blood and spoken with you. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you so much.